Hey guys, this is Josh, just coming to you to talk a little bit about Philippians chapter 4, verses 1 through 9. We're in the midst of kind of our Bible reading plan with Philippians, and it's been pretty cool so far to just see how packed this small letter can be, even though it's only a handful of chapters. But I wanted to talk to you just about what the Lord spoke to me about and kind of what it's been encouragement to me reading this specific passage. So what's cool, first of all, is that I was asked to give a summary kind of what has taken place in these nine verses, and it's God's cool timing and stuff, because this is actually the verse that we chose to pray over for our daughter, Sloan. And we chose this kind of while we were in the hospital in the midst of turbulent time with COVID-19 stuff, and not knowing what exactly was going to be the outlook for kind of family stuff or what our hospital stay was going to look like. And the Lord really just, we actually wrote for weeks before she came on our mirror in our bathroom this verse. And I think it offers us a real cool opportunity to understand the peace that we have available as followers of Jesus, even if there is crazy times around us, a lot of unknowns or a lot of fear. So let me just start by going over the first couple of verses. In verses 1 through 3, there's kind of this conflict that Paul brings up between some people named in the church there in Philippi. And he doesn't give what the disagreement was or what exactly happened, but he does commend them and call them to unity, and saying that their mind should be of one, they should be of one mind because of the basis of the gospel that they share together. So he's basically kind of saying labor together and encourage this conflict or whatever to be soothed over because of the unity that you can have in Christ. And then he goes on in the next couple of verses, verses like 4 through 7, to talk about the peace that we can have in the midst of anxious times, that we should be able to have joy and joy because of who Jesus is, even if there's anxiety around us. And so he says that the way that we have peace in our lives, and he says this in verse 6, don't be anxious about anything, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. So if we desire to have peace in anxious times, if we desire to have security and an attitude of peace that is at our very core, then one of the ways that we can do that, Paul affirms, is through bringing things over and letting things be made known to God. That's talking about prayer. So one of the ways that we as followers of Jesus can have peace in anxious times and joy in anxious times is by bringing things over to God in prayer. And don't, I know that sounds like a Bible study answer or like a very common thing to say, but prayer is a mighty tool. It's at the basis of every person I've ever looked up to in faith. People who are great men and women of God have had an attitude where they've grown to learn how to bring things over to the Lord in prayer. So don't take that lightly, because there's a cool promise in here. It says that, and the peace of God, the peace that comes from God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. So the peace that comes from God will be in your life, and it comes because of Christ Jesus, but it surpasses all understanding. That's kind of a way of saying like there's supernatural peace, peace that can't be explained by the circumstances. Almost as if to say there might be no reason for you to have peace in your life except for the fact that it was given by God. So things might be going completely to crap in your life. They might be very fearful. You might have a lot of anxiety, but the promise that Paul mentions here is when we bring things over to the Lord, then God can work through that to guard your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus so that you can have security and peace in him. And then he ends with saying this in verses 8 and 9, that one of the other ways that we have peace in our lives is also in verse 8, by dwelling what's true, honorable, just, pure, lovely, and commendable, excellent. If there's anything worthy of praise, think about these things. Or another word for that is dwell on these things. So surround your mind and heart with these things. Honorable, true, just, pure. And my challenge to you guys is this: think about what you input into your heart and brain. Are you listening to music that's not honorable to God? Are you watching movies and TV shows that are not honorable to God? Are you spending time doing things that are not honorable to God? All of those impact the peace that's in your life. So Paul is saying that when you dwell on these things that are honorable, then he says in verse 9, practice these things and the God of peace will be with you. We have access to God in peace when we surround ourselves with what's honorable to him. not only that, but he also says the way that we have peace in our lives is by practicing these things. What you've learned and received and seen in Paul, we're supposed to practice these things. So the challenge there is dwell on things that are honorable to God and you'll receive peace. Not only that, but practice what you have learned in Jesus, and that will also help you bring peace. So all of these things, bringing things over to the Lord in prayer, dwelling on things that are honorable to God, and practicing the things we've learned in Jesus will all help to bring you peace in turbulent times. And my hope is that just like we were praying over baby Sloan, that you guys would experience that same freedom and peace that comes from the Lord and him only supernaturally, even when there are turbulent times. All right, guys. Hope you enjoy Philippians 4:1-9.